teach abroad programs, or going solo. There are so many different ways to teach English abroad, and in this video, we'll take a look at the differences between teach abroad programs and finding teach abroad jobs on your own. What is a teach abroad program? There are two main kinds of teach abroad programs. The first kind is normally sponsored by a government of the country where you're teaching, or could also be sponsored privately, and it's to place native English speaking teachers in local classrooms as language assistants. The second option would be to do a TEFL course abroad. So you typically complete your TEFL course and then you can stay on in that country while studying the language, for example, and work in local schools or private academies. Both of these options are great for people who are new to teaching abroad and want to try it out for 3, 6, 10, or 12 months. Language assistant programs have absolutely exploded in Spain, and I predict that they will just continue to grow. But there are also options in France, Hungary, Japan, South Korea, Hong Kong, and more. TEFL Teach Abroad programs are available in even more countries all over the world, and after just 4 to 6 weeks, you'll be TEFL certified and ready to teach. Now that you know what a Teach Abroad program is, I just wanted to give you a special invite to my masterclass, which is coming very soon, on the 5 myths keeping you from packing your bags and teaching abroad. In this masterclass, we'll look at the common excuses people make that keep them from teaching abroad, how to overcome this, and plus I'll be sharing some of my teach abroad secrets. And I've been teaching abroad for 11 years, so I have a lot of secrets. So make sure you sign up for this masterclass, which will be live in the description down below. Let's take a look at some of the pros of Teach Abroad programs.
Number one, some programs provide support such as help with the visa process, accommodation, and orientation, and more. These vary greatly from program to program. Number two, unlike international school contracts where you are often locked in for a minimum of 2 years, Teach Abroad programs are typically between 6 and 10 months long. Number three, if you want to try living abroad, Teach Abroad programs are one of the easiest ways to get a visa to live and travel abroad. Number four, you won't need to interview at a bunch of different schools. Instead, you'll complete an application which may or may not include an interview and receive a placement in a school. Number five, for most Teach Abroad programs, you don't have to be a certified teacher. You most often need at least a bachelor's degree in any subject and possibly a TEFL certificate. Number six, TEFL courses abroad have fewer eligibility restrictions than government-sponsored programs. This means that people without a degree and non-native speakers may be eligible for these programs.
Do some of these Teach Abroad programs seem too good to be true? Well, let's take a look at some of the cons.
Number one, some of these programs have fees, huge fees. For example, some of the fees for Teach Abroad programs in Spain are over $1,000. Fees vary greatly from program to program. Number two, if you are a certified teacher, some of these programs might not be a good fit for you since you're more of an assistant than an actual teacher. Number three, some programs have restrictions based on citizenship. This can be very discouraging for non-native speakers. Number four, the pay isn't great. You often receive a stipend instead of a salary, and depending on where you're teaching, you might be living from paycheck to paycheck. If you want better pay, check out programs in Asia.
How can you find Teach Abroad jobs on your own? If you've already done a Teach Abroad program, or maybe you're just a bit adventurous, then finding your own Teach Abroad job could be a good fit. There are so many different ways to teach English abroad. There are public, private, and charter schools, international schools, language schools, in-company business classes, private academies, private tutoring, and even summer camps. If you'd like to travel and teach and don't like the idea of staying in one spot for the whole school year, then this can be a great option as well. So, what are the pros of finding your own Teach Abroad jobs?
Number one, you can negotiate your pay. Most Teach Abroad programs pay you a set amount that you can't change. Number two, you can choose a place where you teach instead of randomly being assigned to a school. This also gives you an opportunity to speak with current and former teachers at that school. Number three, you can teach more specialized English like test prep or business English. In most Teach Abroad programs, you're teaching children, but when you teach independently, you have more options. Number four, you might be able to bring your family. Some Teach Abroad programs don't allow you to participate in the program if you have a spouse or children.
Now, let's take a look at the cons of finding Teach Abroad jobs on your own.
Number one, there are a lot of scams. You could be scammed by a recruiter or school if you choose to teach independently. You need to be aware of common scams and red flags. Number two, it's likely that the visa process will be your responsibility. Number three, finding jobs on your own isn't recommended if you've never lived abroad before. Number four, it's helpful if you speak another language so you can avoid scams and better negotiate your pay.
I hope this video shows you the difference between teach abroad programs and going solo. Which option is better for you and why? Leave a comment down below. Don't forget to sign up for my live masterclass, and if you're even just a little bit curious about teaching abroad, then you won't want to miss it. You can find me on Instagram at ESLTeacher365, and please like, subscribe, and share this video if you learned something new today. To find out what it's like to teach in Spain, you can watch this video next. Happy teaching!